Welcome back to another vlog, Accountability Culture in Action. And this really is something to savour because it's the Christmas special edition. I want to start with a very impressive debut. The Lost Daughter, directed by Maggie Gyllenhaal and adapted by her from the novel by Elena Ferrante. Olivia Colman plays Leda, a shy academic on holiday in a Greek island who comes across an American family whose little girl suffers a trauma that Leda, with her weird sixth sense for childhood unhappiness, knows how to fix.
It's been a weird day. We found her and then she lost her doll.
I used to have a doll like that, called Mina.
Mina?
Mina. Or Mini Mama, as my mother called her. You'll find it.
Yeah.
See you tomorrow.
The little girl's mother is played by Dakota Johnson, and young Leda is played in a series of flashbacks which run alongside the present-day action by Jessie Buckley. Leda's troubled early emotional life illuminates her current behaviour and also amplifies what appears to be the classical reference in her name. Leda's actions are deeply strange, dysfunctional and predatory, and Leda herself seems to be on the verge of a breakdown. Colman's performance is great because it is always teetering on the brink of some new revelation about Leda. Her face is subtly trembling with something. What? Tears, laughter, a scowl of scorn or derision. And her own sexual life is an unstable entity. The pool boy Will, played by Paul Mescal from Normal People, seems to find her attractive, but she has no idea how to react to this. And the attentions of the apartment manager Lyle, played by Ed Harris, put her into an embarrassing tiz. This is a beautifully controlled and performed film, and it gives Olivia Colman what might be her best role yet. Complex, contradictory, a person struggling with inner emotional pain and pleasure, the present and the past. Irish filmmaker Benjamin Cleary makes his very impressive debut this week with Swan Song, starring the excellent Mahershala Ali in an elegant, melancholy sci-fi mystery with touches of John Frankenheimer's Seconds or Alex Garland's Ex Machina.
I'm going to count you down from three. And on three, and two, and one.
Three.
I can't lie to my family anymore.
The second you tell your wife that you are dying, your opportunity to do this is gone. You want to go say hi?
Ali plays Cameron, an artist and graphic designer who in the not-too-distant future is married to Poppy, played by Naomi Harris, and they have a small son. But there is a problem. Cameron has a terminal illness and fears revealing this to Poppy will devastate her as she is only just getting over a family tragedy. So he approaches a new biotech firm headed by the enigmatic Dr. Scott, played by Glenn Close. Dr. Scott is offering a strange new service. She can create an entirely healthy new carbon copy of the patient, an exact organic humanoid doppelganger with all his memories, except the ones about this procedure, which will be described to the unwitting spouse and family as a business trip. The copy then returns home to slot right back into the family, while the original self-sacrificially lives out what remains of his life on the remote island owned by the corporation. But of course, Cameron is going to have second thoughts once he is confronted by his uncanny other self, sensing that the double also resents him. It's a very intriguing film, and one that right at the beginning seems to be pointing at a huge final twist, a twist that I would have betted was definitely going to happen. But in fact, this film keeps you guessing, and Mahershala Ali gives an outstanding performance. Okay, that's it. I'm now logging off, or should I say vlogging off. On balance, I'll stick with logging off for Christmas, though this channel will reactivate in the new year. Can I please now reiterate my demand that you subscribe to this channel and leave a comment to say that you've subscribed? And also, smash your piggy bank into a million dangerously sharp, glittering pieces and buy my book, The Films That Made Me, an edited selection of my essays and reviews for The Guardian. Buy it for yourself, buy it for your friends and family, but, you know, buy it. Have a lovely Yuletide. Be seeing you.